Welcome back to another Kubernetes service introduction video. In this video, we're going to look at type load balancer. Now, in the previous videos, we looked at why we need Kubernetes services, how they work, what they do, as well as the different types. The last one is type load balancer that we're going to discuss now. Let's assume this is our Kubernetes cluster, K3S, running on Civo, and we have here different nodes within our Kubernetes cluster that are all within, here. So, now we have external traffic. This is traffic through which we want to access our Kubernetes cluster, right? It's external traffic, and that will allow us to, that's coming to our Kubernetes cluster and it's like, knock, knock, can I please access the application? The application, however, is here sitting nicely chilling within our different pods that are running within our nodes. Now we can set up a cluster IP. For instance, a default type for our Kubernetes service. And we can then serve the traffic that's coming in here through additional rules, something like an ingress, something like external load balancers, and so on, to access our application running within our pods, within our nodes. However, let's say we just want to try it out real quick, right? We can use type load balancer. Now, a load balancer basically as type service, so this is our service, will allow us to dynamically route the traffic between the service to those different pods here running within those different nodes. So we will be able to access from the outside world through an external IP address our application running within our Kubernetes cluster. Now, I'm telling you to be careful with this because this will literally open up without many additional rules an external IP address to your application. So that's why in most cases you would want to use an ingress or service mesh of sorts that utilizes an ingress to access your application from the outside world. So this is the outside world, outside, and this is our walled garden within our Kubernetes cluster. Walled garden. And we want to keep it a walled garden, right? We want to keep our applications running securely within our Kubernetes cluster. If we open it up to everybody here, this might expose us to vulnerabilities. So we want to generally use something like an ingress or a service mesh with an ingress, which is a bit something like issue or linkerd or something. So this is our service mesh. And the service mesh usually use an ingress as well. And that's what we use preferred. However, in this case, we want to see how a load balancer works, because a load balancer allows us to, for example, provide really, really easy demos. So going back to our terminal, as you can see right now, we have type load node port running within our cluster. It's not type load balancer. So we want to define within our resource, we want to change type node port to type load balancer. And now we want to apply our update. So kubectl kernel apply. And we want to apply this service YAML file to our namespace example where we have all of our resources running right now. So checking back on our resources, it should now be of type load balancer. And before, we never saw an external IP address defined. Now, in this case, we're seeing our external IP address defined, and this is our external IP address. Now, we can use this address and port 3000 to access our application that's basically accessed cluster right through this port to connect to our different nodes and our different pods within the within our nodes. However, what we want to do is basically just access through the external IP, through the load balancer that we've set up here, our application. So if I now go ahead and I open, well, if I do localhost 3000 right now, it won't do anything because I'm not forwarding it. So it'll just be stuck in loading here and fail. However, if I now access through the external IP, remember, I'm not doing any port forwarding or anything like that right now. I'm just specifying external IP and the port I'm using where my application runs on, like we've discussed in previous videos. So now I'm accessing it and I can see here again my hello world. So the load balancer allows me to dynamically route the traffic, well, through the service to my different nodes here. Let's delete this. To my different pods here. So I could be deleting my pods and it would still work. So let's delete one of those pods. Let's go ahead and oh, here's my load balancer. So this has also been created. These pods have been spun up in addition to it to serve my load balancer, basically. So I can go ahead and kubectl delete my nodes, my pods here. I'm going to delete it, kubectl delete. And I'm going to delete this pod in namespace example. So while this is deleting, I will still be able to access my application, even though one of the nodes, one of the pods is being deleted, has been deleted and spin up again. Because the load balancer type doesn't care, it doesn't care which node, which pod I'm going to connect to. It's just going to connect to any of the ones that are in a healthy and running state. So as you can see, they are in a running state, so I can connect to them. Additionally, set up a daemon set. And this is basically the daemon set, all those different pods that serve my load balancer in this case. So as you can see, I can now access my application from the outside world, from anywhere. Now, as you can see, this is obviously not secure. This is nothing I want to have leave open lying around. This is something I want to use in an instance. If I want to actually provide my application to the outside world, I would use an ingress service mesh to provide additional configuration and do it in a secure manner.